pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. All right. Love God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
The body of Christ. Amen. The blood of Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we have broken your bread and received your life. By the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us always in your love, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We pray together.
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us now to the power of your Spirit, to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. A few notices from this morning. As I'm sure you're all aware by now, due to the coronavirus outbreak, our usual pattern of Sunday and Thursday worship, as well as the Lenten edition of Stations of the Cross and Compline, is on hold until we're told by our Archbishop's permission otherwise. There'll also be no Bible study group, choir practice, film night, or Saturday cafe for the foreseeable future. Just as we've done this morning, Doris, Mark and I will celebrate Mass together on your behalf every Saturday morning, so that you can be part of that and participate on Sunday. So we encourage you to join us every Sunday morning, usual time, to make your spiritual communion. You've all been sent a copy of the Lent service so that you may join in if you would like us to pray for somebody in particular, we'd ask that you telephone me so that I can add that person to the prayer list and include them in our prayers on Saturday. The church will be open for private prayer every morning from 9 a.m. until 12 p.m. As I said in my welcome and in my sermon, if you are able to and would like to volunteer to church sits, this would be very helpful indeed. The more you can help share the task of keeping the church open, the more our building can serve as a place of peace, comfort and prayer over the coming weeks. So if that is something you'd like to do, please do contact me by phone. We will continue to try and run our food bank, though the task of getting food is becoming increasingly difficult. As many of the outlets that we rely on our food for are no longer operating or no longer have surplus stock. If you are able to support the food bank by buying extra provisions for it, then these can be dropped off any morning of the week. If you are self-isolated or know anyone who is and have no one to go to the shops, please contact me so that I can arrange that support to be put in place for you. And if you would like and are able to offer that kind of support, I'd also ask you to let me know. And finally, we would ask you to continue as far as you're able in your giving, your financial giving, that is. This is needed now more than ever, especially since some of our key fundraising activities would have to be suspended and postponed. The easiest way to keep up with your giving at this current time is via our Just Giving page, which is on the website, and this will allow you to make a single or a monthly payment anonymously. You may also decide to set up a standing order to us through your own bank, and I have posted out the details of the church bank account to you. But for those of you who would prefer to go on giving cash in the usual way, via the stewardship envelopes, probably the best way to do this is simply to drop those off any morning of the week and push them underneath the vestry door, and they will be collected and banked in the usual way. And finally, just to say that Edith Halliday's funeral takes place this Wednesday in church at 12:30. Those attending will be asked to spread themselves around the church so as to ensure maximum distancing and safety. Those are all the notices for this week. Thank you very much. So we have our final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May God, who gave birth to all creation, bless us. May God, who became incarnate by an earthly mother, bless us. And may God, who broods as a mother over her children, bless us. May God Almighty bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.